All right, well, Laura continues to weaken, and we keep our eyes peeled on other things that could be headed in our direction here for Florida specifically. Two waves coming off the west coast of Africa, one a little bit closer to the Lesser Antilles than the other, still ways away. The one that's just coming off the west coast of Africa, about a 20% chance of developing within the next 5 days. Remember, most waves don't really become much of anything, but our major hurricanes are most likely from tropical waves. And that's why we like to watch them so closely. The one a little bit closer, really in the center of the Atlantic, still so far away, has a better chance of developing into the Caribbean. However, where would it go after that? Way too early to tell. So the message here is stay tuned. We'll keep you up to date because we are far from over with hurricane season. All right, Glades County, we have a couple of showers moving just north of Palmdale. This little guy we've been tracking for a while headed to Moorhaven within just about 30 minutes at 6:49. Farther to the south, we have a shower just south of 82. This is headed off to Lehigh at 6:51. These storms are moving pretty fast, really downpours, I should say. Not a lot of lightning with this. Only one lightning strike from this storm within the past 15 minutes. This will head into Glades County. Northerly motion with all of these storms. By the time the sun sets, most of these storms will be out of the picture. Glades, Hendry County will have much of the activity for this evening. On Friday, same story. We'll start off dry, partly cloudy. The mornings are nice. They're very humid. A couple of isolated showers from maybe North Fort Myers, Cape Coral, Estero Bonita. But through the afternoon, about this time tomorrow, we will be tracking storms in the same spot that we're tracking them now. Glades, Hendry, Inland Collier. Inland spots will have most of the afternoon activity on Saturday as well. Let's take a sneak peek at your Saturday forecast. 3:30 in the afternoon, a couple of storms starting to line up along 41 and 75. But then through the afternoon and early evening hours, they will remain well inland. So if you are headed to the beaches, looks a little bit drier than areas as you head closer to Lake Okeechobee. By 9 o'clock, we'll have some isolated storms. Stick around for Glades and Hendry, and then we'll fade away and do it all over again on Sunday. Nothing unusual for the next 7 days. We'd like that because we know we don't have anything tropical headed our way. Could that change? Of course it will. It's not even September yet. 93 degrees. We'll have those inland showers around for tomorrow. Here are the next 7 days. Yep, what you would expect. No, low 90s, upper 70s into the afternoon. Thunderstorms each and every afternoon. And more to my message that we got to stay tuned. Take a look at where we are in the hurricane season. We're not at the peak yet. Tomorrow, Jason Dunning will have the latest on those areas that we are keeping our eyes on. And if Laura could regenerate back into the Atlantic. Yeah, that's a possibility, too.
Still got to climb that mountain.
We do. We
scaring me with that graphic, Allison.
You know, Laura kind of was a lot to take in, especially made that close call to Florida. Became such a massive major storm. Yeah, and it's not even September yet.
Nightly News will take you there live next.